We've been completely rebuilding our main street. We've opened up a new library, a new college, a new community center. Our city hall is here. Lots of private businesses, new apartments and condos. And so this project is the next stage of infill development to take that downtown back.
You know how whenever you get a cut and you get the peroxide out of the medicine cabinet and you put it on there and it bubbles it up and it cleans out the cut? We're just doing that on a big scale in the groundwater.
Whenever we're in, injecting fluids into the ground, if you pulse that fluid, that pulsing action does two things. It increases the efficiency of the injection process, and it also increases the efficacy, or how well the product works once it's in the ground, by getting more uniform distribution in the subsurface.
We wanted to avoid the excavation. It's generally, I think, less expensive. And it also avoids a lot of disruption. In this case, part of the contamination extends out under the West Capitol Avenue. And so, you know, not having to excavate the street and, you know, rebuild that and repair that, those are all costs involved in doing that. And this way, we deal with everything in place, and it's a much cleaner, neater, and cheaper way of proceeding.
For too long, we just sort of have turned a blind eye to the assets that we already have, the land that's already in urban places, and we've gone out and developed farmland and sensitive habitat, and we've left existing communities behind. This is about taking back the land, making it safe, and making it possible to rebuild the urban places that have made California so strong.
Take a look at this site, and about within 5 or 10 years, it's going to be businesses and housing. But none of that could happen unless we were able to pitch in to help clean up the site and make it livable for a livable community.